law, in that case we will win because we have said it is sample as well as what? Description. Now very important point, the next one, condition as to quality or the fitness for buyer's purpose. Underline that thing, fitness for buyer's purpose. इसमें कोई भी प्रोडक्ट अगर आप लेते हो तो इट हैज टू बी एज फॉर यूर पर्पस. यानी आपने कोई प्रोडक्ट लिया तो वो प्रोडक्ट जो मार्केट में मिल रहा है, द सोल पर्पस ऑफ दैट प्रोडक्ट हैज टू बी फुलफिल्ड. द वेरी परफेक्ट एंड द जजमेंट विच इज गिवन, ऑफकोर्स इट इज नॉट ए केस ऑफ इंडिया, प्रीस्ट वर्सिज लास्ट का केस है जो आपको मिलेगा. यू अंडरलाइन दैट केस, इफ यू कैन रिमेंबर नेम इट्स फाइन, इफ यू कैंट रिमेंबर देन ऑल्सो इट्स फाइन, क्योंकि सीपीटी में केस स्टडीज के नाम तो बहुत पूछते नहीं है. वॉट वॉज द केस? द प्रीस्ट परचेज ए हॉट वाटर बॉटल. नाउ क्वेश्चन अराइज, इसके सर हॉट वाटर बॉटल क्या होता है? कभी हमने देखा है कि कई बार आप बहुत सालों तक क्रिकेट विकेट नहीं खेलते और कभी कोई संडे को आप क्रिकेट खेलने गए एंड यू हैव रियली वर्कड हार्ड ऑन दैट पर्टिकुलर संडे, तो शाम को फिर आपको दर्द होना शुरू होगा हाथ में पैर में. तो वन बॉटल वी आर हैविंग इन विच देर इज अ हॉट वाटर वी आर पुटिंग, और फिर आप उसको यूज करते हो इन ऑर्डर टू रिलीव फ्रॉम द पेन. दैट हॉट वाटर बॉटल वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट. इन दैट केस उन्होंने एक हॉट वाटर बॉटल परचेज की फ्रॉम केमिस्ट. नाउ जनरली द पर्पज ऑफ हॉट वाटर बॉटल इज स्टैंडर्ड, कि कभी भी आपको पेन हो रहा है हाथ में पैर में, इन दैट केस वी आर यूजिंग दैट थिंग. वो हॉट वाटर बॉटल के अंदर जब दे हैव filled the hot water, it got busted. And at that point of time, Mr. P's wife was using that particular hot water bottle and she got injured because of that hot water. Because in that which hot water we are putting is not an ordinary level temperature. It is slightly more heated one, means more boiled water, which can do severe burns also to your skin if it is burst. So in that case, they filed a case against a company that the product which you are selling is not fit for the buyer's purpose. अगर आप ऐसी कोई product बेचते हो जिसके अंदर hot water bottle है, then that particular bottle should have capacity to store hot water. अगर वो hot water bottle है और उसके अंदर hot water नहीं रह सकता, then your product is not up to mark. And if it is not up to mark, then you are liable to compensate और आपको पैसे देने पड़ेंगे. The very famous case of freeze versus last. Then the next point, dear friend, sixth, conditions as to merchantability. In that point, I would like to say you underline one or two important words. The term merchantability is not been defined in Sale of Goods Act, first of all. Second, but in general understanding, merchantability means what? You write down over there, merchantability means it has to be in saleable condition. Saleable condition. So very much similar to the previous point. इसे भी हम एक सिंपल एग्जांपल से समझते हैं कि इफ यू आर परचेजिंग सम पेन, से इफ यू आर परचेजिंग पार्कर पेन ऑफ 110 रुपीस, यू हैव परचेजिंग सम वन ऑफ द बेस्ट वॉच इज ए रोलेक्स वॉच, इनकरिंग एन एक्सपेंडिचर ऑफ 10,000 रुपीस, 15,000 रुपीस. इफ द सोल पर्पज ऑफ पेन इज टू राइट, इफ इट इज नॉट राइटिंग प्रॉपरली, देन वी कैन से प्रोडक्ट इज नॉट ऑफ मर्चेंटेबल क्वालिटी. आपने रोलेक्स की घड़ी ली और अगर वो राइट टाइम नहीं दिखाती, देन सोल पर्पज इज नॉट सर्व. तो मर्चेंटेबिलिटी सेज कि इफ यू आर सेलिंग सम प्रोडक्ट, तो उसका जो मेन पर्पस है वो तो उसके अंदर होना ही चाहिए. अगर वो नहीं है, देन इट इज अ इम्प्लाइड कंडीशन कि यू हैव राइट टू कैंसल द कॉन्ट्रैक्ट एंड यू कैन क्लेम बैक यूर मनी. तो देर वॉज अ फेमस केस ऑफ आर एस ठाकुर वर्सेज एस जी कॉरपोरेशन. उसके अंदर ऐसा हुआ था कि आर एस ठाकुर वॉज अ लेमैन पर्सन, ही हैज परचेस्ड ए रेडियो फ्रॉम ए ब्रांडेड कंपनी, बट इन दैट केस द रेडियो वॉज नॉट वर्किंग प्रॉपरली. After doing multiple time repairs, then also it was not working. So over here, it was taken that the purpose of radio is not served. In that case, you can cancel the contract and you can claim back your damages. And dear friends, the last one and important, condition as to wholesomeness. Wholesomeness, yani again very much similar to the previous point, ki agar koi product is not in a good condition, you are not supposed to sell it. तो आप एक ऐसा क्वेश्चन होता है दिमाग में, सर हर एक पॉइंट सेम ही लग रहा है, देन व्हाई देयर इज अ सेपरेट पॉइंट, व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन प्रीवियस पॉइंट मर्चेंटेबिलिटी एंड होलसमनेस. सी मर्चेंटेबिलिटी टॉक्स अबाउट सम प्रोडक्ट इन विच यू विल हैव प्रूफ, द होलसमनेस इज स्पेसिफिकली फॉर ईटेबल्स ओनली. देखो ईटेबल्स में आपके पास प्रूफ नहीं रहता, प्रूफ इसीलिए नहीं होता, से फॉर एग्जाम्पल आज कोई जगह पे आप गए, यू हैव परचेस्ड ए पिज्जा, आपने पिज्जा खाया, तो दूसरे दिन आपको पता चलेगा कि वो पिज्जा ठीक नहीं था, आपकी तबीयत दूसरे दिन बिगड़ती है, एट दैट पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम यू विल नेवर हैव प्रूफ। प्रूफ में ज्यादा से ज्यादा क्या हो सकता है आपके पास, यू माइट हैव द बिल ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर रेस्टोरेंट। ऐसा तो होगा नहीं कि आप चार पीस में से तीन पीस का और एक पीस रखोगे संभाल के कि अगर मेरी तबीयत बिगड़ी देन दिस विल वर्क एज ए प्रूफ इन ए कोर्ट कि यही पिज्जा खाने से मेरी तबीयत बिगड़ी। तो ओवर हियर होलसमनेस इज स्पेसिफिकली फॉर इटेबल्स इन विच यू विल नॉट हैव द कॉन्क्रीट प्रूफ दैट प्रोडक्ट इज नॉट अवेलेबल, ऑफकोर्स दैट बिल इज अवेलेबल, बट सी फ्रॉम विद द बेस ऑफ बिल इट इज नॉट नेसेसरी दैट यू विल विन द केस, बिकॉज दैट पिज्जा पर्सन कैन ऑलवेज से कि आपने हमारे वहां पिज्जा खाया उससे तबियत नहीं बिगड़ी है, क्योंकि लास्टली यस्टरडे हमारे वहां तो 100 जन आए थे, किसी की भी तो तबियत नहीं बिगड़ी, आपने कुछ और खाया होगा, तो देयर इज नॉट नेसेसिटी कि आपने कोई एक प्रोडक्ट खाया और आपके पास अगर वो बिल है देन यू कैन फाइल ए केस एंड यू कैन विन द केस। सो ओवर हियर लेट अस रीड द कंडीशन इज अ पार्ट ऑफ कंडीशन ऑफ मर्चेंटेबिलिटी ओनली बट अंडरलाइन बट इट इज एप्लीकेबल ओनली इन द केस ऑफ इटेबल्स, सर्कल दैट वर्ड इटेबल्स, मीन्स इफ यू आर सेलिंग सम प्रोडक्ट any defect which renders them unfit for human consumption, yani upar ke point aur isme kya difference hai ki that was a general product which is not eatable and wholesomeness deals only about eatables. So there was also a famous case if you can remember, Frost versus Aylesbury Dairy, uske andar A sold milk to B, the milk contained some germs and B's wife on milk consumption got infected and died, in that case A was entitled to pay damages. In reality that dairy and all was closed, this is not a case of India, it is case of foreign country, but in foreign country they are quite strict in terms of food department ki agar koi xyz company ne bahut badi galti ki hai then they take away their license. In India it is slightly strange kyunki kai baar aap India mein koi hotel mein jao to wahan pe bar aisa likha hota hai ki admission restricted, yani aap wahan pe kitchen mein ja hi nahi sakte, but in foreign there are many restaurants which are open in sense there is a mirror they will make in front of you, so you can get idea that how much cleanliness is there. And in India still that rules are there but it is not applicable in totality. So this is all about the conditions. Again I would like to say you should remember the points, main point, first one was condition as to title, second condition as to description, third condition as to sample and description, fourth condition as to fitness for buyer's purpose, fifth condition as to merchantability, and the last one condition as to wholesomeness. Now we will go to multiple choice question. I am giving you 10 minutes, you solve it on your own and then we will discuss. As we have discussed implied conditions, now the next point 2.2.4 implied warranties. We know the difference between conditions and warranty. In conditions you have right to cancel the contract as well as you have right to claim damages, but in warranty you have only one right in terms of breach. That is only you can claim damages, you cannot cancel the contract. If there is nothing expressed, dear friends, in that case what are the implied warranties? There are 4 points. The first point is implied warranty as to quiet possession. Now circle that word quiet possession and write down there undisturbed possession. Quiet possession or undisturbed possession are same thing. Means what they want to say, in absence to any contract showing contrary intention, contrary intention means opposite intention, there is an implied warranty that buyer shall have and enjoy quiet possession of the goods. If buyer is disturbed in the enjoyment of the goods, he can claim damages from the seller. Underline that, he can claim damages from the seller. Now reading these three lines, it's again very difficult to understand what exactly they want to say. Implied warranty as to quiet possession. Now let us take an example. Say Mr. Gopi has purchased a new car, but he want to keep the surprise that using that car in his family, he has also planned to go for a long drive to some distance place, say Abu, and to enjoy Saturday Sunday over there with his family. In that case he has brought one car on Wednesday and he was planning to go on Saturday Sunday, but that was a surprise cap, but he has already booked the hotel and etc over there in Abu. Now Wednesday has brought a new car, say for example Tata Indica was brought, And on Friday, the people from Tata company came back and say, okay, sir, there is some manufacturing fault in this particular batch when this car was produced or manufactured. In that case, we will take back your car for some specific purpose. The rework will be done and again we will give you back. Over here, why we have purchased the car? In order to enjoy the possession of that goods. And on the basis of that car only, Mr. Gopi has planned his weekend in Abu and he has already booked the hotel. Now in this scenario, they have taken their asset, so it is disturbance of the possession. And if there is a disturbance of possession by the Tata, in that case you can claim damages. You cannot cancel the contract on this ground, or say we can say they are taking back your car for a temporary purpose, for the repair work. They are not taking for lifetime. In that case we can say that there is a disturbance of your possession. Aapne gaadi li thi in order to enjoy for a long drive to go to Saturday Sunday for a distance place, that is Abu, but that whole plan has been disturbed. So in that case we can say it is a breach of implied warranty and you can claim damages from Tata for the same. Second point, implied warranty that goods are free from encumbrances. Again a technical word, encumbrance. Circle that and write down. Encumbrance means a charge or a debt, charge, charge or a debt, debt. Unless the circumstances of the case are such as shown to a contrary intention, same as above, there is an implied warranty that goods shall be free from any charge or encumbrance in favor of any party not declared or known to the buyer before or at the time of contract is made. Reading again these three lines, it is slightly difficult to understand what exactly they want to say. Over here, you cannot sell some product for which it is already encumbrance. Encumbrance means charge. Say for example, I am having one two-wheeler, that is bike. Against that, I have taken a loan of rupees 20,000. So in that case, you have taken a loan of 20,000 from Mr. Z. In case if I am not refunding 20,000, you can take my bike. Now this same bike, if I am selling to someone else, that is Mr. Z, so in that case we can say you have breached the implied warranty, means the product on which there was already a charge, and on that you are supposed to pay 20,000 to Mr. X previously, to whom you have taken a loan. So over here we need to understand you cannot sell the same product to Mr. Z legally, otherwise we can say there is an implied breach of warranty. That is point number 2. Third point is very simple. Warranty as to usage of trade and customs. Now usage of trade and customs, the lines given either in our module of ICAI or any of the reference books are only two lines. That implied warranty as to quality or fitness for the purpose may be annexed to the usage of trade and customs. Now trade and customs is very versatile thing. Now we need to understand over here, okay, sir, isme koi example jo hame yaad rahe. See, trade and customs means the things which are coming from the olden era, jo barso se hamare wahan pattern aati rehti hai. Say for example, hum kai baar dekhte hai ke pure India mein there is a trend or all over the world there is a trend ke shaadi ke baad ladki ladke ke ghar pe jaati hai. Now literally if you will read the old books, say one of the oldest book is Rig Ved, Yajur Ved, Sam Ved, Athar Ved, which you might have studied somewhere in standard 10. लेकिन कोई भी पुराने बुक में ऐसा लिखा ही नहीं है कि दिस इज ए पैटर्न विच वी नीड टू फॉलो, बट इट इज ए ओल्डन ट्रेड एंड कस्टम्स थ्रू आउट वर्ल्ड के शादी के बाद लड़की जनरली लड़के के घर जाती है. नाउ द सिनेरियो इज चेंजिंग, बराबर, नाउ ऑपोजिट थिंग्स ऑल्सो टेक प्लेस, लेकिन जनरल ट्रेंड है. कहां पे लिखा है? कहीं पे भी नहीं. इट इज एज पर ट्रेड एंड कस्टम. तो इफ सम दैट टाइप ऑफ ट्रांजेक्शन आर टेकिंग प्लेस, से फॉर एग्जाम्पल इन राजस्थान एंड अदर पार्ट, इवन टूडे शादी में हमने देखा है कि कई बार जो दूल्हा होता है, इट ही कम्स ऑन हॉर्स, मीन्स द पैटर्न इज डिजाइन इन सच ए वे कि इन मैरिज जनरली द जो दूल्हा होता है ही इज ऑलवेज कमिंग ऑन द हॉर्स. नाउ इन दैट पर्टिकुलर केस आपने जिससे ट्रांजेक्शन किया था कि भाई आई विल टेक हॉर्स फॉर 10,000 रुपीज फॉर दिस पर्टिकुलर डे, ऑन दैट पर्टिकुलर डे इफ दैट पर्सन डिनाइज कि भाई आज हॉर्स तो है नहीं, सॉरी, any other animal is there, do you want to take it? In that case we cannot replace horse with buffalo or any other type of animals. Horse means what? Horse. It is trade and customs. If you are not following that thing, in that case you have right to claim damages from that person. if that person is not giving you horse on that particular day of marriage, you can claim damages from them. That is what we can understand in a concise manner, that something which is going on from olden era that we need to fulfill. If it is not fulfilled, in that case we can say it is an implied breach. Why implied? Because we need to understand that for marriage only horse is required, no other animal is the replacement. Of course, many times we have seen that nowadays people are coming on elephant also, they are coming on helicopter also, but now that is a modern era. But what is general trade and custom? That people are coming on horse. Now that all things are olden thing, now people are also coming in car, but only for the understanding purpose we have taken that example. Fourth and last point, warranty to disclose the dangerous nature of goods. Now see, in reality also our Indian law is that much more refined, that when you are dealing in any type of dangerous goods, see over here dangerous goods means we are not talking about bombs and etc, we are talking about general product which is risky in nature. आपने देखा होगा कि घर में कई बार आप लोग यूज करते हो बेगोन स्प्रे, हिट, काला हिट, लाल हिट एक्सेट्रा एक्सेट्रा. इन दैट केस देर इज ऑलवेज ए नोट प्रिंटेड इन 13-14 लैंग्वेजेस. डियर फ्रेंड, 13-14 लैंग्वेजेस में वो लोग लिखते हैं कि दिस आर द प्रोसीजर्स टू यूज इट, यू नीड टू यूज हैंकरचीफ ऑन यूर नोज, आपको छोटे बच्चे से वो चीज दूर रखनी है. तो द रूल्स आर प्रिस्क्राइब एंड इट इज रिटन इन लॉ कि इफ यू आर प्रोड्यूसिंग एनी टाइप ऑफ प्रोडक्ट विच इज डेंजरस इन नेचर, देन यू नीड टू हाईलाइट that total things, okay, what precautions you are supposed to take. Yani, let us see the content, what does it says. In sale of dangerous goods, the seller is under an obligation. Obligation means he has to do that, to warn the buyer about the probable danger. Failure to do so, if you are not warning, you are not writing a note, in that case seller is liable to pay the damages. Yani, agar aap aisi koi product banate ho jisme kya dhyan rakhna hai, अगर वो आपने नहीं लिखा, then you are liable. But as I said in very first starting of this unit, कि if it is written, यानी अगर आपने उसके अंदर लिख दिया है कि आपको ये ध्यान रखना है, this is expressed, और अगर आपने नहीं बोला, then it is fine. If it is expressed, then you are not liable for damages. लेकिन अगर express नहीं है, then you are liable for damages. So that is the reason कि when they are selling any type of dangerous nature of goods, every time they are coming with a note. हर एक जगह पे आपको दिखेगा, सिंबल होगा, कहीं पे उन्होंने लिखा होगा कि कीप इट अवे फ्रॉम 3 इयर्स चिल्ड्रन, यूज इट इन दिस पर्टिकुलर मैनर. अगर ये लीक हो जाए तो यू थ्रो वाटर ऑन दैट पर्टिकुलर थिंग और थ्रो सैंड ऑन दैट पर्टिकुलर थिंग. सो दैट इज ऑल इट इज मेड मैंडेटरी बाय लॉ. एग्जाम्पल, एक्स सोल्ड ए टिन ऑफ डिसइनफेक्टेंट टू बी नोइंगली दैट इट वॉज लाइकली टू बी डेंजरस टू बी इफ ओपन विदाउट स्पेशल केयर. मीन्स इट वॉज ए दैट टाइप ऑफ डिसइनफेक्टेंट, अगर आपने उसे ध्यान से नहीं ओपन किया और अगर वो पाउडर थोड़ा सा उड़ा और वो आपकी आंखों में गया, तो देर इज अ प्रोबेबल डेंजर टू यूर आईज. इफ दैट टाइप ऑफ प्रोडक्ट यू आर डीलिंग, इट इज इम्प्लाइड दैट यू नीड टू इन्फॉर्म टू द बायर कि प्लीज डू टेक केयर वाइल ओपनिंग दिस थिंग. यू हैव सीन मेनी टाइम्स कोको कोला एंड पेप्सी आर ऑल्सो दैट टाइप ऑफ प्रोडक्ट, कि अगर आप उसको थोड़ा सा हिला के ओपन करते हो तो देर इज ऑलवेज अ पॉसिबिलिटी, मीन्स इट विल बस्ट अप लाइक एनीथिंग. तो इन दैट केस it is not dangerous nature Pepsi and Coca Cola, so it is fine. But if something is of dangerous nature, you need to always highlight it the same in advance. So whereupon the disinfectant powder went into her eyes causing the injury, then seller is liable to pay. That is all about the implied warranties which is important for exam. So we need to remember all 4 points. All 4 points are, again I am summarizing it, implied warranties as to quiet possession means undisturbed possession, implied warranty that goods are free from encumbrance, the third one warranty as to usage for trade and customs, and the last one warranty to disclose the dangerous nature of goods. Now we will shift to the last segment of unit 2.2.5, doctrine of caveat emptor. The word caveat emptor is a Latin word. So first of all, let us understand what exactly is caveat emptor. In general English, the doctrine of caveat emptor, that is underlined, let the buyer beware, means that the buyer while purchasing goods must act wise and select appropriate goods which will be fit for, again underline, his purpose. He should be careful to see that goods purchased will serve his purpose well. Now question arises, sir, okay, we got idea ki exactly what is caveat emptor, means let the buyer beware. Now let us another understand it in another sense. See, no seller will sell the product stating that there are defects in this product. Let us take our own example. Say if we are selling something, hum khud bech rahe hain XYZ product. Hame pata hai ki ye product ke andar ye 10 cheez achhi hai aur ye do cheez barabar nahi hai, there is some defect. But that two defect we will never tell to the buyer. Agar aap apni product mein defect dikhana shuru karoge, then no one will purchase. So over here what is important, seller will never tell the defects in his product. Yani buyer needs to check properly before purchasing product. Aap purchase karte waqt dhyan hi nahi rakhte aur uske baad har bar aap goods le aake bologe ki it is a fault of seller and seller is liable, so that is not a case. Seller will never tell that there is product in my product. It is buyer who need to check goods properly before purchasing. So there are various case which is not explained in note, but I would like to say ki we need to understand that case is for fundamental clarity. In foreign there was a case where X person was selling his all pigs. Now generally in India we are not dealing in pigs and etc, but in foreign they are dealing. So there was an advertisement in newspaper. In newspaper it was said that he was planning to sell all his 800 pigs with his good and bad health. It means that it is now express all pigs are to be sold in auction with his goods and bad health. Goods and bad health means along with whatever health they are carrying on. Now Mr. X has purchased all 800 pigs, but after a while all out of that 800 pigs many pigs died, and the pigs which were originally owned by X, some of them also died because of some contagious disease was there. Now he filed a case against the original buyer, the person who has given an advertisement that pigs which you have given to me are not of good health, and because of that particular pig there was some contagious disease, and as well as your pigs or some of the mine pigs have also been dying because of that disease, and kindly provide the medicinal expenditure and etc for the same. The court held that ke over here the original buyer who has given an advertisement to sell their pigs is not liable to compensate, because while doing an advertisement it was expressed in a clear manner that there was a sale of 800 pigs with their good and bad health. Good and bad health indicates that whatever I am selling, it may be good, it may be bad. If you want to purchase, then purchase, otherwise it was an optional. It was not a mandatory contract by force. In that case we can say that you are not liable for compensation. Means when you are purchasing any product you need to check carefully. Let us take another example which is very familiar in India. Many times there is a sale. In sale they are highlighting in a focused manner, say defective sari sale. Say if it is a defective sari sale, in that case aap wahan pe gaye, do char sari kharidi aur ghar pe aake jab aapne check kiya to uske andar defect thi. In that case you cannot file a case against the shopkeeper stating that condition of merchantability, ke bhai agar aap sari bechte ho to it has to be reasonable and it has to be proper. यहाँ पे आप केस जीत नहीं पाओगे. द रीजन इज वेरी सिंपल, क्योंकि उन्होंने पहले से ही बोल दिया था, इट वॉज एक्सप्रेस्ड इन नेचर कि इट इज डिफेक्टिव साड़ी सेल. अगर वो डिफेक्टिव साड़ी सेल है, आपने वहां से गुड्स खरीदे और आपने ध्यान नहीं रखा, तो इट इज यूर फॉल्ट, मीन्स बायर्स फॉल्ट. सो केवियट एम्प्टर सिंपली मीन्स लेट द बायर बीवेयर, मीन्स बायर शुड टेक केयर बिफोर परचेजिंग दैट टाइप ऑफ प्रोडक्ट. नाउ लेट अस गो फॉर मोर सिंप्लीफिकेशन. इट इज ए सिली एग्जाम्पल बट ओनली फॉर अंडरस्टैंडिंग. आपने देखो बीवेयर वर्ड बहुत सुना होगा. आप कोई भी बंगलों में जाते हो तो बाहर लिखा होता है बीवेयर ऑफ डॉग. मीन्स वॉट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ बीवेयर ऑफ डॉग? वो लोग बाहर ऐसा क्यों लगते हैं कि बीवेयर ऑफ डॉग, वहां पे एक डॉग का फोटो लगाते हैं? वॉट इज द पर्पज? द पर्पज इज वेरी सिंपल, कि हमारे वहां एक डॉग है, अगर आपको अंदर एंट्री लेनी है तो लो, लेकिन इट इज एट यूर ओन रिस्क. आप अंदर आए और अगर हमारे डॉग ने या हमारे कुत्ते ने अगर आपको काट लिया तो उसकी कोई भी मेडिसिनल कॉस्ट वी आर नॉट सपोज टू कॉम्पनसेट. सी इन रियलिटी वी आर स्टडिंग ए पार्ट कोर्स ओनली इन सीपीटी, लेकिन देर आर मल्टीपल लॉस. इन दैट वन ऑफ द लॉ इज लॉ ऑफ टॉर्ट्स, विच इज नॉट इन अवर सिलेबस. लेकिन वहां पे कई बार ऐसा लिखा है कि अगर कोई पर्सन की प्रॉपर्टी है, उससे किसी को डैमेज हुआ, मीन्स से आई एम हैविंग वन एलिफेंट, वो एलिफेंट की वजह से अगर किसी को डैमेज हुआ टू अवर नेबरर्स, देन आई एम सपोज टू कॉम्पनसेट बिकॉज that damage is because of that elephant and elephant is my property. In that case if you are entering some bungalow and that person is having dog, and if that dog bites to someone, then dog is a property of that owner of bungalow, so he is supposed to compensate. लेकिन बाहर नोटिस लिखने से क्या होगा कि दे हैव वॉर्न्ड यू कि भाई वी आर हैविंग वन डॉग, सो बीवेयर ऑफ डॉग, सो इफ यू आर एंटरिंग एट योर ओन रिस्क. सो ओवर हियर केवियट एम्प्टर मीन्स लेट द बायर बीवेयर, मीन्स बायर शुड बीवेयर बिफोर परचेजिंग द प्रोडक्ट. एवरी टाइम वी कैनॉट से दैट सेलर इज लायबल. नाउ इफ बायर इज नॉट केयरफुल एंड ही फाइंड्स लेटर ऑन गुड्स दैट डजंट सर्व हिज पर्पस, देन ही कैनॉट अंडरलाइन he cannot hold the seller liable for it. Now very important for examination, exception of caveat emptor. Exception means we know very well ke in those scenario now buyer is not liable, who is liable? Seller will be liable. Exception to caveat emptor, the first serial number. Buyer depends on seller skills and judgment, then seller is liable. See very simple thing and golden rule which we should always follow. अगर आपको कोई भी चीज लेने जाते हो और आपको पता नहीं चलता कि व्हाट एग्जैक्टली इट हैज टू बी, यू पुट टोटल बर्डन ऑन सेलर ओनली. यानी अगर आप लैपटॉप लेने गए, कंप्यूटर लेने गए, देन यू टेल देम कि आई डोंट नो एनीथिंग अबाउट लैपटॉप, आई फुल्ली रिलाई ऑन यू कि आप मुझे जो प्रोडक्ट दोगे ये सब परफेक्ट ही होगी. अगर वो परफेक्ट नहीं है तो इन दैट केस यू हु विल बी लायबल, नॉट बायर, सेलर विल बी लायबल. उसका एक एक्सेप्शन है विच इज रिटन व्हेन गुड्स सोल्ड अंडर ब्रांड नेम और सम एबनॉर्मलिटी इज देयर, देन बायर डज नॉट डिस्क्लोज सेम टू सेलर, इन दैट केस बायर इज लायबल. तो अगेन वेरी ऑड स्टेटमेंट. तो लेट अस रिलेट विद ए रियल केस. रियल केस में क्या हुआ, लेट अस टेक एन एग्जांपल कि वो यूएस से इंडिया में आया, जनरली दे आर वेयरिंग जैकेट्स इन विंटर, बट दिस टाइम ही हैज परचेस्ड, दैट पर्टिकुलर लेडी हैज परचेस्ड स्वेटर. नाउ सी वॉज हैविंग एन एलर्जिक विद वुलन क्लोथ्स, but that allergy that lady has not disclosed to the seller. In that case she cannot file a case against the company or that shopkeeper that product which you have given is not good for me and therefore seller is liable. See in this particular case it is an exception. If some xyz person is having allergy of woolen cloth, we cannot state that it is a error of seller who has sold the goods. How seller will get idea that XYZ person is having allergy unless and until the buyer himself discloses. So that is an exceptional case, so we need to understand. Second point, sold on description. If goods are sold on description and if it is not as per description, then again seller is liable. Goods are sold on sample basis and if it is not as per sample, then again seller is liable. And in the example which we have taken earlier, ke agar aapne sona ya sola kalyan या ऐसी कोई भी प्रोडक्ट आपने गेहूं की ऑर्डर दी है, देन इट हैज टू सेम एज पर यूर सैंपल. आपने अगर कल्याण प्रोडक्ट सिलेक्ट की है तो आपके घर पे जो गेहूं आएंगे वो कल्याण के ही होने चाहिए एज पर यूर सैंपल. थर्ड, सोल्ड ऑन सैंपल एंड डिस्क्रिप्शन टुगेदर, द एग्जाम्पल विच वी हैव टेकन फॉर वेट एंड अदर थिंग, अगेन सेलर इज लायबल. द फिफ्थ पॉइंट, इम्प्लाइड वारंटी एंड कंडीशन फॉर ट्रेड एंड कस्टम्स. एज वी हैव डिसाइडेड कि इन एंशियंट एरा, मल्टीपल एग्जाम्पल विच वी हैव टेकन, the pattern which is flowing of trade and customs we need to follow. If we are not following, in that case seller is liable. And the last one, if goods are sold by wrong representation or fraud, in that case seller is liable. Now again question arises, sir, how do we understand that it is by fraud and wrong representation and seller is liable? Aap koi xyz jeweler ke wahan gaye, aapne usko 50,000 rupaye deke ek gold ornament liya, और आपको एक साल के बाद जब आप बेचने गए तब आपको पता चला इट वॉज नॉट ए रियल गोल्ड, इट वॉज ए कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ डिफरेंट मटीरियल बट नॉट रियल गोल्ड. इन दैट केस अगर आप ज्वेलर के पास वापस गए और आपने बोला कि भाई ये आपने तो गलत गोल्ड दिया है, इट इज फ्रॉड, इन दैट केस दैट ज्वेलर कैन नॉट से कि लेट द बायर बीवेयर. आपको खरीदते वक्त ध्यान रखना चाहिए ना, ये तो आपकी गलती है, मैं तो कुछ भी बेचू, ऐसा नहीं चलता. इन दैट केस इट इज नोन एज फ्रॉड एंड सेलर इज लायबल टू पे. तो दीज आर द एक्सेप्शन where buyer is not liable, who is liable dear friends? Seller is liable. That is all about caveat emptor, means let the buyer beware. So dear friends, over here we can say unit 2 is ended. In unit 2, summarize form what we have studied today. In that case we have started with the difference of warranties and conditions, then we have understood the implied conditions, then implied warranties, then we have started with the caveat emptor which was recently ended, that is let the buyer beware. Over here unit 2 ends. Now let us start with the MCQs based on unit 2, and after the ending of MCQ we will shift to the third part, that is unit 3.